in May of 2021, Austin, Texas voted on Proposition B, which made it illegal for the growing number of homeless flocking to Austin to camp anywhere they please. The vote was 57% in favor and 42% against, according to the Travis County Clerk's Office election data.
People have no reasonable expectation of privacy in public spaces, where their actions, content, and possessions can be seen or conversations heard. Again, whether the content at issue is physical or virtual. Examples of such places are public sidewalks, venues hosting sporting events, and public parks. There is no reasonable expectation of privacy in discarded garbage left in the street.
The homeless had been promised permanent housing from the council, which never materialized even after millions were cut from much-needed public safety and diverted towards housing the homeless. When the day arrived for Proposition B to be enforced, the first area targeted was City Hall, which had fallen under siege by what appeared to be the homeless, but that was an illusion. I had been informed by the defunded Austin Police Department that they were well aware that the people now shouting threats and racist diatribes in their faces weren't homeless. The majority of them were activists.
I issued a criminal trespass warning for the people around Austin,
was
Java. That was 11
tips. We were asking for, listen, we were being extraordinary, asking for voluntary compliance to not block buildings, right?
So we moved the 11 tips over there.
So listen, this endeavor is separate and distinct from saying, hey, I'm just doing education outreach. That's a courtesy. This has never been legal.
The reality is that the liberal activist group Homes Not Handcuffs had organized the siege in protest of the will of the Austin voters. Supporting that protest was the majority of the now absent city council and other wealthy Democrats hell-bent on turning Texas blue. Again, manipulating the legitimate vote and will of the Austin voters. And per usual, the local police would have to endure the task of playing the role of the bad guy while enforcing the people's vote. To make matters more undemocratic and totalitarian, the organization behind Homes Not Handcuffs is Act Blue, the insidious George Soros tax-exempt political organization, an organization where billionaires dump money into pseudo-grassroots movements designed to throw a wrench in federal, state, and local government foolish enough to allow the minions of Soros' lies to fester. Act Blue was once described in a human rights article as, quote, not driven by the average Democrat, as their image may suggest. They are rather mouthpieces for the radical agendas of the likes of Soros and labor unions.
You really need to bring China into the creation of a new world order.
George Soros has been a controversial topic. His past is well known and his enemies are many. But after the media defended his public image recently, he had fallen off the radar, which gave Soros and those that would dismantle the United States enough time and cover to reinforce their radical activism infesting major U.S. cities. It became accepted common knowledge, and although it is completely antithetical to the survival of our republic, U.S. politicians have done relatively nothing to stop it, and it's been ignored by media as it grew. A message to the fools surrounding City Hall. The majority of you aren't even from Austin, much less Texas. Your blatant insult masquerading as a protest has only caused the taxpaying residents of the city of Austin to become increasingly infuriated, and your cover has been blown. You'll be lucky if we don't find a way to put all of you behind bars for meddling in the results of our local ballots. As for the residents of Austin, Texas, this is no conspiracy theory. It is easily verifiable. George Soros and his employees have laid siege to your city hall. John Bowne reporting.